ride some bucking horses. Everybody say yeah. It all starts tonight with Dan Birch and a John Duffy bucking horse that we call the Tweety Bird. Come on, kick him. You've been waiting a whole year for that to happen. How about you make a little noise for a CFR rookie, would you? Huh? He's pumped up, stick it on him. Dan Birch. Well, on the back of a bucking horse from the John Duffy Rodeo Company, that sorrel mare that we call the Tweety Bird, that was the matchup. The marks are coming to us from our five Wrangler Pro Rodeo officials. Half for the bucking horse, the other half for the cowboy. Let's ride.
All right, we'll get the score. It's 82 and a quarter starts us off today. Now to J.R. Vazane, one of the Americans that have qualified to be here at the Canadian Finals. Calgary bucking horse. Javier Joan, help him, help him, come on. That is a great Calgary bucking horse right there. A great cowboy from down south joining us tonight as well from Wyoming. Get him on the ground, give him a little Canadian hello if you'd like to. He's a great guy. You're going to enjoy watching him for the next five nights after this. Vazane, our 2012 Canadian champion, goes to number one, 84 points, 84.
Get back. Hey, well, how about that for a start? When you want to talk about enjoying watching a bareback rider, well, we have enjoyed watching these two men in our arena, two of the greatest ranch race cowboys anywhere in the world, in your words, buddy, and we mean it. That is the icon, that is Mr. Gary Rimple, but he's back making his sixth appearance. Jason Resch is back in the house on a Wednesday night as we crack a match for Ty Tippitat and Wayne Vold's Deal In. Now, when you want to talk about a story, this cowboy's got one. Middle of the season, we put him out of contention. He had what we thought was a season-ending injury. This is his first rodeo back. He switches riding hands. Come on! I want to tell you a story about that cowboy. The last 10 years, he's rode bucking horses with his left hand. That is the first horse he's ever gone on right-handed. He battled a bicep injury all season long. He has not missed a beat. Welcome Ty Tippitat back to the arena. 82 and three quarters for Ty Tippitat. 82 and three quarters. Whew, wow.
How about we take a look at the young guy from Okotoks, Alberta, Pascal Isabel. It's his first CFR in the pro ranks. He's been here in the novice ranks before, and tonight he's got a horse from Wayne Vold called Up and Smoke. We saw this mare here last year. This is a great pen of bucking horses tonight. Kind of might even call him a little bit of the hoppers. You're going to like this one right here. All right, somebody scream at him one time. Oh, this is going to be a great journey this week, ladies and gentlemen. We've got so many great young, fresh-faced youngsters that have qualified this year. It's certainly going to be a great shot for some underdogs to win the Canadian title. It pays over $12,000 every round of competition for six rounds. 79 and three quarter. He got by the first one. That's the most important part. Good job, Pascal. Nice to have you, buddy.
We're cleaning them up and clearing them out. We're taking it out of Cody Lamb. Cody Lamb from Sherwood Park, Alberta. It comes into his very first Canadian Finals rodeo in the pro ranks, but another cowboy that's had huge success in this arena. He is a former CFR novice bareback riding champion. He's currently hanging out in the United States of America as he goes to school down there, working on his master's in psychology. Well, tonight the test is the Calgary Stampede's Tootsie Roll, and this is a handful in a pen of hoppers. Come on, Cody. Yep. You can help. As Jason Resch and Gary Rimple move on in, I'm a Ram Rodeo pickup man. Hey, Sherwood Park's just over the hillside. Let's treat them like a hometown hero, would you? So Coney Lamb does what he has been doing time after time, matches up the Great Bucking Horse of the Calgary Stampede, and he is in at 81 tonight. Mark it down in your souvenir program, 81 for Lamb.
We got a pair of brothers that qualified last year to go to Las Vegas for the Wrangler NFR, Oren and Tyrell Larson from Manitoba. Yeah. Dallas Steam Sexy Bucks, that's the name of the bucking horse from Outlaw Buckers. This is a veteran horse. The Cowboys love this horse. They make a lot of money on this horse. Come on, Oren, tonight's your night. Let's get it started off the right way. Come on, let's ride. Yeah, buddy. We have a little noise out there. He can hear you. He can hear you. The two-time National Intercollegiate Rodeo Association champion college bareback rider. But I saved the best part of the story for last. As we're waiting on the score to come in right now, folks, he's headed to Las Vegas again. He's number two in the world right now, headed for Las Vegas. 83.5 for Oren Larson.
All right, we're going to keep on keeping on, and let's talk again about the return of a cowboy. Michael Solberg from Sunny Nook, Alberta, took a few years off of the CFR, but he's back, and for good reason, because he rides right. He will match up tonight with Wayne Bold's Dancing Queen, a bucking horse that we have seen at both the Canadian and the National Finals. Rodeo, let's ride with him. Yep. Yep. Oh, that is our music director, sharp as they may convince you, Ben Lee. It is so great to have you back in Edmonton. How about you welcome Michael Solberg back as well? How about a little something, something, would you? Michael Solberg is in at 79 tonight. 79 in a tough pen. A bareback riding so far, Mr. Brooks.
Oh, buddy, let's take a look at Kai Marshall now from Bowden, Alberta, Canada. Starburst, the bucking horse from the Kessler Rodeo Company. That's the same stock contracting firm that was awarded the bucking horse of the year in the bareback riding. It's a horse called Must Have. This one, Starburst, is a big horse, 1,300 pounds, and they won a round here at CFR a year ago on this very bucking horse. Kai Marshall comes to us, trying to win it, trying to get going. He needs a little help. Come on. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. He has become one of our seasoned veterans here in the bareback riding, making his fourth trip back to the CFR. He is one of our Canadian college champions back in 2011 as well. Let's get him on the ground. He can hear you now with an 81.5 for Kai Marshall.
Well, from just the north side of Drayton Valley comes one of the greatest bareback riders of all time in Canadian professional rodeo history. We come to what we refer to as the left-hand delivery side, where we find the three-time Canadian champion, Kyle Bowers. Yep. That is a bucking horse that they call Showboy from C5. Hey, how about you pick him up and dust him off, huh? That is one of our great bareback riders. Kyle Bowers makes his 16th. Yeah, hear me roar, 16th Canadian Finals Rodeo appearance. Wow, yeah, pretty impressive number. The five-time Canadian champion, I might add. Well, the numbers are coming in, 80.75, 80.75 for Kyle Bowers.
All right, let's talk about maybe one of the most technically correct bareback riders we have here tonight. The last three guys to ride are the three highest money earners of the year. This is Jake Bold. Jake Bold from Pinoca. He's the reigning Canadian champion bareback rider. He won it a year ago. Garden Party from Kessler's. He's been selected to be at the Canadian Finals and the National Finals in Las Vegas. You want one of the best matchups of the night? Here it is right here. Number 10 in the world. Twice to the Wrangler NFR. He is well headed to Las Vegas. Eight Canadians are going to Las Vegas this year, huh? How do you like that? Like come on, Jake, let's it. Ride.
More of it.
Come on, help him. Come on. Woo.
my.
That ain't no hopper, buddy. That's a handful is what that is. That first little couple of jumps out of the buck and shoot. We're going to give you a look at it one more time. Showing the yank. This is the event that takes a toll on a cowboy's body more than any other event in our rodeo game. Two-time reigning Canadian champion goes to the number one spot, 84 and a half.
Play it like a champion.
Buddy, when you started our show tonight, you said, hey, welcome to a Saturday night. It's starting to feel like it, isn't it?
You bet.
Big scores as we take you to the other side of the action right now. We're going to Cole Goodnight from the County Stampede, a bucking horse by the name of Exceptional Margarita. This is a six-year-old bay mare that comes to her second CFR. Stay with him. How about it for Cole Goodine? We bring him back, and here's a guy that is in the canoe. He's all right, huh? How about you make him feel just a little bit better, would you? Whew. Wow. That guy right there, Cole Goodine, has had one of the most consistent seasons all year long. Finds himself in the number two spot. He's in tonight at 81 and a quarter, 81.25.
How about back to the Calgary Stampede herd and a young stud bucking horse called Walleye Rocket. He's a lunatic fringe bucking horse. There's a good shot of the handhold of Caleb Bennett. This is the season leader. He came in number one. He has not won a Canadian title, but he's ready to win it this year. Come on, Caleb. Let's ride. Yeah. That's the third member of our 12-man field that's headed to Las Vegas,
sir.
That should show you what kind of quality control we've been talking about all night long to the media companies all around the CFR. Scores rolling in. He's going to have to beat 84 and a quarter. That's where Jake Gold's at right now. There's a beautiful go-around buckle that will go to the winner of each and every one of our performances, each and every one of our rounds, and more importantly, the 12,000 over 12 that will go to the first place man. Caleb comes in with a nice spot for the number two money. Hey, it all spins the same. 84 for Caleb Bennett. 84. Nice riding, boys. That was fast and that was furious. How'd you like the bareback riding, everybody? How about it one time for all the boys?
Well, what a start for the two-time and reigning Canadian champion in our Alberta Premium Bareback Tiger Competition. How about it for Jake Fold at 84 and one quarter tonight. Jake, good ride.
You grab a 400-pound steer by the horns and you throw him on the ground. That's all there is to it. Sounds easy when you say it fast. All right, get it rolling, Brock. Get it rolling. I'm waiting for the light at the far end of the arena. There's no light. He got out clean. How about a 3.8 and the crowd goes wild? Wow.
Wow. That guy right there, that is a great feeling. I don't know if he's feeling great right now. Looks like he was kind of faint from that arm as he was leaving there. But it has been a 9-year absence for Brock Butterfield. We are so excited to have that guy back here where he belongs as we are now going to take you to yet another second-generation steer wrestler. His name is Rowdy Hayes. You might say Rocky Mountain House, but he'll spend a lot of his time in the south part of our great province. Ladies, I'm sorry. He's officially now been taken. Well, he got married a few weeks ago before this year's CFR, and he needs a little money, honey. It makes the world go round, okay? We watched his dad, the great Hubert Hayes, in this arena, the Cowboy of the Year. Well, now it's Rowdy's turn. One of two Bulldog brothers as he slides behind that barrier. We want to remind you guys, we'll talk about it in a minute. Come on, Rowdy. Yeah! 4.2 seconds of the four-time announcer of the PRCA. Wayne Brooks just said to me, wow, what a great Hayes. That is Ty Miller on the Hayes inside. That is actually Ty Miller's bulldog and horse they call Chico. You watch him bump it right there. And that's what it's all about. You think you got to be a great steer wrestler? You need a great Hazer on the other side. That's good teamwork. 4.2.
Wow, that was a great job. Okay, I want to make sure that everybody feels good. We want to make sure that everybody feels comfortable here tonight. So do me a favor, okay? Everybody all at one time. Turn around, find somebody you don't know right now, shake their hand and say hi. Go ahead. Make a new friend. Come on. Come on. Make a new friend. Can we be friends? Huh? Come on. Let's make friends. Okay. Tell them where you're from. Tell them how many kids you got. Give them a kiss on the mouth. I don't care. Just get to know them. There you go.
You got a friend in me.
Derek Frank, ready to roll. The second of the four Frank brothers that we're going to watch in our arena tonight for this year's CFR. We watched Dallas, Frank, three or four different times.
Yep.
This is the first crack at the old kick at the cap for old Derek Frank, Stony Plain, Alberta. 6'1", 220 pounds. He's a baseball player.
Yeah, he's a good one. This whole family, and of course, his other brother, Travis, holds the arena record right here at the Canadian Finals, a 3-1. What an impressive family they are.
Is a 3.7 possible? Of course it is. If you'll buy a program and look in the back, you'll know all of our arena records, all of the champions of the CFR, all of the great stories of yesterday. They're in that program. I urge you to get a hold of one. It's a little piece of history that you cannot undo. Come on, come on. Hey, this steer wrestling is starting off awful tough tonight. 4.2, no penalties again. Nice run, boys. Nice run.
Now, when talking about that Frank family, there's his brother Derek, the man that you previously mentioned. He was on the Hazen side of that run. We're setting up just like we were in a bareback riding. It doesn't feel like a Wednesday night. Feels like a souped-up Saturday night as we get you ready for our next steer wrestler. The cowboy that's been here in the past, Dusty Walker from Vanscoy, Saskatchewan, comes to his fourth consecutive Canadian Finals, and he rides his horse by the name of Tank. Tank has been a former Canadian steer wrestling horse of the year. He'll be one of two cowboys that'll be riding Tank here this week. Yep, he's ready. Let's go. No time. Well, no time right there, so it is not going to work for Dusty Walker. That's not how he wanted to start, but here's the deal. He's still got five performances left. There's a lot of money on the line, and it pays over $12,000 a round.
I'll tell you what, second place, third place is not bad either. $9,200 for second, $6,000 for third, about $3,000 for fourth. Here comes Stephen Culling from British Columbia. How many folks here tonight from BC? Where are you? He just won the 2016 PRCA South of the Border Rookie of the Year in professional rodeo. Yeah, Stephen Culling, 22 years young. Big bucks in Pinoca at the finals there with a five flat run. 8,000 in the bonus round of Pinoca helped get this youngster to the forefront of Canadian rodeo. Pistol. Great horse under the saddle as well. Come on. Get a hold. Slide, hit, turn. Smooth run. 5-8. Northlands is home to a 31,000 square foot urban farm, 10 urban beehives, and 7 urban hens.
Huh.
Did you know that a horse's height is?
Well, it's measured by hands, if I'm right. Do you know how much a hand is?
I do. Do you?
I do.
Okay.
How much? No, you go for it.
Okay. 4 inches.
Yeah, right on.
All right.
Be sure. Good stuff.
Tanner Milan is our man right now, Cochrane, Alberta. It's his 12th trip to the CFR. Two-time Canadian champion as well. Oh, boy.
Turn down for what?
Oh, boy. I can't hear you. How about a 3.6 for Tanner Milan? Wow.
Okay, now it's time for a little history lesson. You look back to 2014, Tanner Milan won the first round and he went on to win a Canadian title, okay?
Yeah, buddy.
Oh, he's got to sweat 5 or 6 bulldoggers still, but if that holds up, what a storyline that would be. They're already starting to build on a Wednesday. As we take you to our next steer wrestler, we're looking at a young gun by the name of Brandon Lay. Now, he comes into us as a semi-pro champion. I had an opportunity to watch Brandon Lay over the past 3 or 4 years. He's a guy that can not only bulldog, he can ride bucking horses. He comes from a Hall of Fame family.
Now as Brennan gets ready to slide on into contention behind that barrier, he is one of three Steer Wrestling rookies this year. On a three and a tough to crack field of competitors, he rides a horse that belongs to Bo Anderson. Now both Brennan and Curtis Cassidy will ride this horse this week. Last thing I want you to ever do is underestimate how important a horsepower is in the Steer Wrestling. Gotta stand like a statue in that corner, and then you've got about two strides to go from about 0 to 30 miles an hour. We had a bit of a misfire right there. Oh. Well, he goes to take a leap of faith, and I will tell you what, for the past 2 months, that young man has known that he's qualified for the Canadian finals. That is not how he played round one out in his mind. Could you do me a favor and make that CFR rookie feel just a little bit better?
That's why we have, as we said in our opening, the greatest fans in rodeo. Thank you, folks, for being so nice to our cowboys and our cowgirls. Here comes Scott Gunther, Consort Alberta, returning for his third trip back to the CFR. He comes in ranked number 5 this year. Last year, he was the season leader. Last year, he had a stranglehold on the number 1 spot coming into the CFR. This year, he's got a little bit of ground to make up, but not much, about $15,000. That's only one night. If you can win, plus a little bit more the next night. Not too bad. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, that a boy. Hey, that's all right, 4.6. You also are seasoned veteran fans that come each and every year. They know what a difference that average makes as well. So we pay out all this money over 6 performances, but you have to keep in mind there's another $12,300 that will go to the number 1 guy who does it the best out of anybody over 6 days. So you don't have to win every round.
That's right. And we've seen it year after year when that average comes into play. There's a guy that's placed every round, maybe hasn't won a round, but ends up winning a Canadian title because it might be 6 performances, but you got 7 chances to win money. Speaking of a guy that has won the average, here's a guy that's done it. We look to Curtis Cassidy, one of the winningest time event cowboys in professional rodeo history, and I don't just mean Canada. Curtis Cassidy comes into his 31st Canadian Finals rodeo between the Steer Wrestling and the tie-down roping competition. Now, he was the runner-up to the 2015 Steer Wrestling title, and he won that average. He won almost $40,000 out of this arena last year. He wants to do the exact same thing. There's a guy that is so calm, so cool, and collected, and he has been for the better part of 2 decades. He backs on into that corner. All right, Kurt. It's about getting off to a good start, and he knows how important that is. Ready? Come on. I need you to do me a favor, and I need you to start putting your hands together because it's more of a round of applause and consolation right now. If you look back and you see that red light right above our timed event end, that red light indicates to us that he broke the barrier. He left just a little bit too early. He did not give that steer the required head start. That means a 10-second penalty on top of that total run time. So we look at 17-7 for Curtis tonight.
Welcome back to Benji Bentley, cranking out the tunes. From way down south in Texas, Straws Milan riding into the box right now. This is the second of 3 brothers, Bailey. You can bet your bottom dollar he's running around somewhere trying to help his brothers. These 3 brothers are tough. I mean, tougher than boot leather. They can fight bulls. They can make a circle around a barrel. They can get in the barrel once in a while. They'll get in the wild cow milking. They can throw a rope once in a while. They're just all-around hands. That's all there is to it. 5th trip back to CFR for Straws. One of the things that helped him get here was a big win in Calgary. Oh, no! At the Cinch Series Finals. Well, not tonight. Thank you for the consolation round. I do appreciate that. And thank you as well to Edmonton Destination Marketing Hotels for everything to see and do in Edmonton. ExploreEdmonton.com.
They are great corporate partners, us, and of course, they were our hosts last night at our Night of Champions, and we got to recognize all of our CFR competitors, all 108 of them, at the River Cree. Thank you so very, very much to those guys. They've been great hosts. We've taken out a Morgan Grant. Now, Morgan Grant is the only cowboy that comes into the CFR this year in more than one event. He's a steer wrestler, and he's a tie-down roper, and he's a former Canadian High Point champion. He rides a horse that he owns and operates by the name of Bumps, and here's another guy that's off the market, ladies. He just got married this year to a former Miss Rodeo Canada. Couldn't be more proud of Morgan and Jillian. All right, Mo, let's go. Come on, buddy, hustle. Yep, yep. 5 seconds flat on the hair trigger stopwatch of Maxine Baird and Brent DeVold, the two timers that are joining us up here, well, for the past little handful of years, we'll say, for these two lovely ladies. So 5 seconds flat for Morgan Grant.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there's nothing wrong with giving a little bit of noise to a cowboy before the competition. The next man to ride the box is the four-time and the reigning Canadian champion. It's Cody Cassidy, Denali, Alberta. Wish him some luck out there, will you? You bet. An NFR qualifier as well, comes from that famous family. He's riding Tank, the horse of the year that my partner talked about a little earlier. That helps things. You met Brother Curtis a moment ago. Come on, Cody, let's go, let's go, let's go. Wow, smooth run. That'll keep him in the running as the season leader. He's only got about a $9,000 head start on the rest of the field, so he's going to have to whip up and kind of stay consistent as the week goes on as well. Folks, there is a lot of talent coming across that arena, but right now, we're bringing you the number one guy. How about a hello to Tanner Milan? 3.6. Attaboy, Tanner. Attaboy. ...2015 Canadian champion. Jay Simpson on the healing side. Claire's home, Alberta. Woo! I'll tell you what, for a team that didn't rope together all year long, that was an awesome run to start them off. No penalties. How about 4.9 to start the team roping? Oh, no time. Oh, illegal head catch. Illegal, I should say. Shoot. Yeah. There's only three legal head catches. It's got to be one of them or you're out.
That's too bad. Love that team and I love that story, but here's the same situation. Let's go to Clint Bueller on the head side, a six-time Canadian Finals Rodeo qualifier. And on the back side, he's a living legend. He is an icon of the team roping industry. His name is Rocky Dolan, and he hails from Nanton, Alberta. He's the winningest healer in Canadian Pro Rodeo history, and that's why. Yep, nice run as the flag comes down, courtesy of our flag field official, that is Lane Peterson, a horseback. 8.1. Now you say, 8.1, maybe a little longer than you want it to be. Well, that's okay, because let's talk about that average. It's never too early to talk about the average. Could be that 8.1 that keeps him in contention come Sunday.
Well, absolutely, and if you look right here on the bottom and look right here on the top, only about 12 grand separates the team, the number one team from the number 12 team. So that's one night. That's winning in one night. Here comes the bottom team on the ladder. Kyle Smith, Brad Alberta, Spencer Rutherford, Merritt, British Columbia. You want to talk about talent? The man on the healing side, they say, have yet to see him in action, but they say he's one of the fastest guys to the horn with his rope of anybody going down the road today. We're going to find out here in about 10 seconds. Smooth and easy. The key to success. Great horses. We talked about them in our steer wrestling. Welcome to Trish Bedard, our manager of the CFR, doing a great job putting it all together this year. Here we go. Clean them up on the healing side, no problem. 8 and 7. By the way, as we welcome our year-end award winners, congratulations to the Dress Act of the Year award winner for this year, Nikki Flundra. Comedy Act of the Year, Dennis Halstead. Stock Contractor of the Year, Calgary Stampede. Congratulations again to yourself.
Hey, thank you, sir. Appreciate it very much.
You bet.
Okay, let's take our next team of Team Rumpers. We're bragging on Casper Roy and Steel Napoli. Steel Napoli on the head side for the Longview Ranches. Well, the Buffalo Head Ranches in Longview, Alberta. The Napoli family calls home. He's on a horse called Badger, former Head and Horse of the Year. Casper Roy on the backside comes to yet another Canadian Finals rodeo on his good horse, Bam Bam. Yep, had to send it. You watch him gather things up on the heel side as they come tight. The flag goes down. 7 seconds flat for Casper Roy and Steel Napoli. And I'll tell you what, Mr. Brooks, these guys were responsible for so much drama this year. They did not qualify for this CFR till the last day of the regular season. They won the round, they won the average, and they're here. Well, they're making it work. 7 seconds, that's going to put them into the top spots.
That'll work, by golly, that'll work. Thank you to Martin Deerline. Everyone wants a John Deere, right? Whatever the project, Martin Deerline has what you need to get the job done, official tractor of the CFR. Let's try it now with Travis Gallet from Red Deer. Devin Wickmeyer from Brooks. 21 years old. No pressure, though. No pressure.
You know, every team rope that I talked to about this kid, he said, you never know he's 21 years old. He comes in with this cool confidence. Of course, we watched his father in this arena before. It don't matter if he's backing in front of 5 or 500,000. This is a kid to watch.
Canadian champion on the head and side can handle the steers the way they need to be handled. Former rookie of the year as well. 3-time Canadian champ. Travis Gallet, backed in. Nod, swing, and a throw. Yeah, buddy. Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, that 21-year-old's feeling down right now. Let's pick him up a little bit before he's out of here, will you? Keep your chin up.
We're taking you now to the next team. Let's go to Garrett Rogers, Baker City, Oregon. Jacob Miner, Ellensburg. Take you to the Pacific Northwest. On the head side, Garrett Rogers comes to his second consecutive CFR. Here's a guy that was kind of a teenage phenom. He spent his teenage years as a healer, then moved to the head side, has had a tremendous amount of success, and that is why. Come on, yep. Yeah. How about a little more for 5.1 seconds? Miner and Rogers, and when we talk about the teenage phenom on the head side, Garrett Rogers, you watch him throw that rope. He absolutely sends it. He's not even in the frame, and he gets that steer caught. And that's what it's all about. Those two gunslingers are going to be two to watch, 5-1.
I would put the McCarroll brothers up against any team roping duo, anytime, anywhere, any day. Here they are. They've won the Canadian title together a couple of times. They've won the average championship here a couple of different times. Justin on the head and side, Brett on the heel and side. Yep, no problem. How about a 4.9? Clean run, boys. Good roping. Good roping.
I'm stealing it right out of your playbook, okay? We asked you a little while ago, we said, you know what, it's okay to make a little noise before the Cowboys compete. But here's why I think this one is special, because the next team coming on in is Levi Simpson and Jeremy Bueller. Well, as of a couple of weeks ago, these two Cowboys made history. They became the first ever Canadian team to qualify for the Wrangler National Finals Rodeo in Las Vegas, huh?
Bueller.
How about that for making history? Levi Simpson's a Canadian champion on the head side, and I suggest you fear the beard on the backhand. Look what you did. How about 4.5, and the crowd goes wild. You know what, in our opening tonight, we said we got the greatest rodeo fans in the world, and I'm putting that one on you guys. You sent them a little energy, and it worked out. 4-5 for Levi Simpson and Jerry Bueller. Nice run.
You catch one of the contestants after our performance tonight and say, hey, does it make a difference? Can you hear the crowd? You bet it does. These cowboys and girls feed off of what comes out of the grandstands. And here, it's always been a perfect place for that crowd to get involved. And it does make a difference. Clay Hildery, Riley Wilson to the heels. Yep. Put them together with two. Clean run. 6 and 9. Weren't you telling me Riley Wilson just won 50 grand?
Yeah, he did just a couple of weeks ago. Now at the USTRC National Finals, he won the 15. He paid him, I said, 50 grand? He said, yeah, 50 grand American. So that's not bad in the current state of our country. I'm not sure. Maybe he better cash that check before the election last night. I don't know what's going to happen with that dollar, okay?
I don't know.
Maybe it'll work in his favor.
Make America great again, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah.
We're going to find out, I guess, aren't we?
Yeah, we are. We're going to your two countrymen right here, Dustin Bird, Russell Cardoza. Dustin Bird and the headside hails from Cut Bank, Montana, the 2012 Canadian champion. Third trip to our Canadian finals, and he will make his fourth trip to Las Vegas at the Wrangler National Finals. From Terrebonne, Oregon, on the Heelan side, it's a CFR rookie, but no stranger to the winner's circle in professional rodeo. That is Russell Cardoza. Russell, his first CFR, but he's qualified for his fifth NFR. Pretty impressive lineup right here. Big wins this year. We watched him win Ayrton, Hand Hills, High River, Leduc, Armstrong, and Wainwright.
Something's wrong.
Something is wrong. Man, I'd have bet you the ranch 10 times over that those guys were going to move to the lead, but it does not work. Hey, could you guys do me a favor? How about you make them feel just a little bit better? Could you put one hand on the other, huh?
How about Colton Schmidt, number 3 in the world, talking about NFR and all of our great contestants that are headed down there in our team roping this year. That's going to be great watching for 10 nights from Las Vegas. Colton Schmidt, Barhead, Alberta. Shea Carroll, Hyco, Texas. It's his first time to the Canadian Finals, and he's ranked number 3 in the all-around right now. It's a big deal. Shea Carroll's been to our National Finals. He's a former college champ as well. Colton Schmidt, 13 Canadian champion. Oh. His dad, a Canadian champion, the next generation. The first year they were here, and Colton Schmidt got out of here with that Canadian title. We called them the Biscuit Snatchers. They were so young. Don't let them get out of here without a little something, something, something. You bet. It's always nice to have something on your back. Yep. Think about when you go to bed at night.
Our final team in our Ritchie Brothers team roping is going to be Brett Buss and Clay White. The team from Alberta, they come in the number 1 spot again this year. They did it 1 year ago. They're the back-to-back season leaders in, well, one of the toughest, most competitive events we have. You know the neat story about this team, and I absolutely love telling it? They're first cousins. It's going to be a huge thing for this family when, you know what? Your kids, they're cousins, they grew up together, they rope together, and this just ain't anywhere. This is the biggest and best rodeo on all the land. Big reach on the head side, Clay White on the back end. Yes, you did. Yes. How about 5.1? That moves in to the number 3 spotter, a tie for it with Rogers and Miner. Brett Buss and Clay White, 5.1 seconds. When you look at it, 9 out of the 12 teams were successful here this evening. That is going to set up a little drama as our week unfolds, but there has been nobody better than this team so far, so good. Ladies and gentlemen, how about it for Levi Simpson and Jerry Bueller here tonight? 4.5 seconds. They are.
Here comes the reigning Canadian all-around champion, Josh Harden, Big Valley, Alberta, and a Calgary bucking horse called Waning Moon. Now, we mentioned in the bareback riding kind of a hopper pen tonight, sort of, not totally, not 100%. This pen of Bronx, yeah. It's a whole nother story. Wow.
It's scary. Here we go. Here it starts. Come on.
Perhaps he was kidding around. There's no kidding around with our pro officials. The flag hit the ground, and that signifies the mark-out rule. You have to have both feet above the shoulders the first jump out of the bucket chute, or else it's a no score. Now, Waning Moon bucks a lot of guys off. That man got along with him just fine, but you have to have the markout rule. Watch the next rider. When he nods his head, he's going to stick those feet above the shoulders. It has to be done. It gives the livestock the advantage.
Well, as we welcome back Jason Rash alongside Gary Rimple, our Ram Rodeo pickup man, we now draw your attention to Audie Reed, our next prong pioneer. He matches up with Shane Franklin's Evening Mist tonight. Evening Mist, the name of the bucking horse from one of the greatest rodeo ranches in the history of professional rodeo. All right, Audie. Yeah.
Oh,
come on. Oh, man. Hey, I'm going to say something to Texas one time, would you?
Don't ride the white horse.
That horse was a handful, as we see on our rematch replay. There is nothing easy about him. When Shane Franklin brings you a big gray bucking horse that's been both our Canadian and national finals, you better ride and ride right. How about it for Audie Reed? 83.5.
Our next man from South Dakota spends a lot of time in the summers here in Canada. That's why he ended up winning this year Sundry, Lee Park, Strathmore, Medicine Hat. He has had a phenomenal summer. Chuck Schmidt, Calgary, South Dakota, his second trip to the CFR. 2008, we watched this young guy take the collegiate championship south of the border. Tonight, he's teamed up with Boudelier from Duffy Rodeo Company. A young stud bucking horse that was here a year ago, and he's a handful, just to say the very least. Most of the livestock you watch here at the CFR will compete twice within our 6-day period of time. Come on, Chuck. Wow. Come on, come on, come on, charge, no.
Don't worry.
Wow.
Be happy.
Oh, I don't think he's going to be happy. Boy, watch that big leap out of the shoe right there. He didn't have a real, in Chuck's defense, he didn't have a real solid pattern. He's kind of just a little bit up, a little bit off, kind of hard to get in time with. And here in the saddle bronc riding, timing is everything. If you're out of time, you're going to hit the ground.
Certainly. Yeah, well, here's another horse that can get you to the arena floor a little early. That 8-second buzzer, you don't do things right. Dusty Hossauer, who hails from Dickinson, North Dakota, will match up with the Calgary Stampede's Shoshone Mountain. Now, you mentioned it a couple events ago. You said the Calgary Stampede's are 2016 Stock Contractors of the Year. Well, this is one of their award-winning bucking horses. 7 of the 12 horses tonight have either been a horse of the year, a horse of the CFR, and this is one of them. In 2008, that man left here as a Canadian champion, but he leaves here tonight with his chin on his chest. Can you help him feel just a bit better, everybody? Wow, that's a bucking horse. Shoshone Mountain tells you and shows you why. That horse has been named the bucking horse of the Canadian Finals Rodeo. No score for Hossauer.
So we go from one end of the spectrum to the other. We got a kid that's here for his first time as a pro. He won the Novice Championship a year ago. Lane Cust from Sylvan Lake, Alberta. He is the 2016 Rookie of the Year and the permanent award winner. And what I mean by both ends of the spectrum is he's got a veteran bucking horse. Franklin Rodeo! Come on, Lane, come on, Lane! That big bucking horse from Franklin Rodeo called Just My Luck. 16 years old, we've seen that horse here a lot of times at the CFR, in the bareback riding and the bronc riding. You get by that one, by golly, you should be able to hold your head up. He's in the number 2 spot, 76 3/4. Good ride for Lane Cust.
You know, we said it might be a Wednesday night, but it's a night we can make some magic. And this is one of those matchups. Jake Watson from Hudson Hope, British Columbia, will match up with Wayne Bold's bucking horse that we call Eclipse. This horse is going to weigh in at about 1,400 pounds, and a horse that has twice been the bucking horse of the Canadian Finals. But Jake Watson has found his groove. 2016's been a special year for this man. Not only does he qualify for the CFR, he qualifies for the national finals in Las Vegas. Wow, come on, help him out. That horse is a mythful. I don't care what the numbers are. You need to stick it on him. Jake Watson needs some love. Oh, that bucking horse is a load right there. Man alive. Jake Watson from Hudson Oak, BC, the Wrangler National Finals Rodeo qualifier, former CFR qualifier in the novice saddle bronc riding. He had a big bucking horse underneath him from Wayne Bold tonight, the award-winning Wayne Bold, one of our previous stock contractors of the year. He's in at 72 for Jake Watson.
All right, let's go to the Butterfield family. I think it's illegal to have a CFR without a Butterfield member here. Luke Butterfield, an awesome from Wayne Vols, two-time Horse of the Year from the National Finals Rodeo. Come on, Luke. Attaboy, attaboy. Gets off the hard way tonight, but it's all right. I bet he's going to be fine. Luke Butterfield is number one in the all-around race right now, only by about $1,000 over Josh Harden. And he goes to the number two spot as well. Luke, 82.5 tonight, 82.5. I'll tell you what, if you're 84 or more tonight, you will have done something.
This is not an easy set of bucking horses, not by any means, as we take an opportunity to thank the city of Edmonton. And what does it mean? It means plenty of activities for everyone. Party, eat, drink, shop, and dance your way through Edmonton. What a beautiful city this has been. And like we got to recognize tonight, it was the mid-70s. The CFR came to this lovely city for 43 years strong. As we're ready to turn them loose, it's Sam Kelts, Millerville, Alberta. The Calgary Stampede brings us a bucking horse that we call the Weary Joke. Now, Sam Kelts has been here on many of occasions like his father was before him. This is his 11th trip for the former Canadian season leader. Now, Sam is matched up with the 7-year-old brown mare that I meet will test your waters from the 2016 Canadian Pro Rodeo Stock Contractors of the Year. Keith Merrington, the entire team, our ranch manager, Tyler Kraft, along with Kenny Rahill, the man we call Goose. Let's do it. Yep. I know that we've asked a lot of you tonight, but you guys have been oh so gracious, but we need you one more time. That is a great young man, and he could use a little love from you guys. As we watch it back on that Remax replay, we might have a, well, and right side, we kind of had a better vantage point, kind of hung that foot in the front end, rolled him in or away from his rein, we should say. You watch his vantage point, looks like he's going to hang that front foot in there, maybe just a jump up, loses that stirrup. If the case, no score.
About 11-time CFR qualifier, Jim Berry from Rocky Mountain House, Alberta. He's a former novice champion, and his dad and brother, Wild Horse Racers. He comes in ranked number 4 this year. But the big story is C5. Vern McDonald brought a horse called Rockstar. They scored an 84.5 a year ago on this horse. Chuck Schmidt did it. A young mare that's easy to be around. When this horse isn't bucking, you can walk up and pet her. She's easy to be around, not hard at all. Come on, Jim. Yeah? Come on, you got it, you got it, you got it.
Hey, I wanna be a rock star.
If you think he deserves some money, sound off one time. What do you say? Oh, boy. Amber, Coy, Quinn, the family, they're going to be happy about night number one. I got a feeling. Anyway, you're going to have to be 84 to take the number one spot. And he does. 84 for Jim Berry tonight on night number one.
Love that guy, love his family, and he's due. Canadian Championship, yeah, I think it's next for Jim Berry. So he set the stage for an ex-bronc rider. Clay Elliott from Nanton, Alberta, comes to the Canadian Finals Rodeo, but he's been here in the past. That name sounds familiar, well, it should. His father, a great cowboy. His mother, one of the nicest ladies that we ever had an opportunity to meet in our industry. We watched his brother Ty ride here in the bull riding. It's time to watch him in the bucking horse riding. Come on, Clay. Ooh, ouch. He beat me to the punch, and my apologies, because I wanted to brag on a bucking horse of the Kesslers that we call the Navajo Sun. The Navajo Sun gets the best of a cowboy that qualifies for the CFR and the Wrangler National Finals this year. That is one of eight Canadian cowboys that has earned the right to compete for a world title and a Canadian title. Well, no score, no mark, and no money for Clay Elliott.
Thank you to Ram. We appreciate you being back. It is in a class all of its own. Here comes Leighton Green, meeting Creek, Alberta. 2012 novice champ. Twice now to the CFR in the open ranks. Airdrie and Dawson Creek, just a couple of spots where he won big bucks this year. Leighton Green's got a stud, one of the rankest horses out of the Calgary herd called Tiger Warrior. They've won rounds before on him. But he might be one of the rankest you watch tonight. Oh, no. Wow. Oh, my. Ooh. Leighton, you all right, buddy? He's smiling, but he's holding that arm. Wow. Huge leap out of there. That's a ranked bucking horse. There wasn't a straight jump in him either. He was to the left, he was to the right, he was all over. I think he was holding that left arm because he got fouled on the shoot gate. That's what the judge just said. They said he gets an option of a re-ride. He gets to do it again. He'll be back a little bit later on during the bull riding to try it again.
It's time to set the stage for what is probably the greatest matchup of the night. It could very likely be the greatest matchup of the entire rodeo. Dustin Funder on the back of Northcott Mutz as champion. Get smart. Yep, come on, Jeff. There was no cowboy that came in tonight's competition with a bigger resume than that one, and there was no bucking horse that came in with a bigger resume than that one. That is superstar versus superstars. We'll await the numbers, but you need to say something to your season leader. How about Dustin Flundra? $82.25 on the back of the horse of the year for Northcott Mutz's. Oh, good stuff. 82.25. Canadian champion versus Canadian champion right there. Well, pretty impressive.
Tell you what, that horse will make you work for it. That's a fact. As we say thank you to Cook County Saloon, it's an opportunity to bring one of our cowboys back, Leighton Green, a little later. But as of right now, the man with the victory lap is Jim Berry. 84 points on night number one.
It's starting right here, right now, with Logan Holford. Familiar face to our Canadian Finals Rodeo, a second-generation Canadian finalist that comes into his seventh CFR. He rides his good horse that he calls Easy. He had some big wins this year. Had the opportunity to watch him win the Strathmore Stampede. He went to the Peace Country, took home titles in both Grimshaw and Lacrete. Speaking of Lacrete, well, they are one of our committees of the year this year. They tied for the top honors in our medium committee division alongside the TP Creek Stampede. Come on, Mo. Yep. Watch as he gets a black calf gavard as he will string the front one, stack the back two, wrap all three. Just like that. Just like that. How about 9-7 to set the pace for Logan Hofer? 9.7 seconds for the McGrath Alberta Cowboy. Now, we're going to remind you, you new rodeo fans, for those of you that just need an update, as soon as Logan Hofer remounted and rode ahead, our flank field officials started a stopwatch. And calf has got to stay tied down for 6 seconds on the end of a loose line. Then we get to make it official, so we do exactly that. Logan Hofer, he's in the books at 9.7.
Nice job. 11 guys just went, oh boy, that's going to be tough. Well, that's a good way to start it off. Set the bar high. Let's go to Clayton Smith. Eckville, Alberta. A first-timer. Here's a young guy that's been spending his college years down in Oklahoma on a rodeo scholarship. Nice guy. Big stout kid, too. Little extra sand in your shorts. Never hurts a thing when you're in the tie-down rope. The average weight on the calves is over 200 pounds. For a lot of folks that aren't rodeo savvy, just because they're short doesn't mean they don't weigh a lot. 200 plus on all of them. Clayton Smith, string them. One, two, and a half hitch. Just a little tiny bobble at the back end. Cost him a couple of tenths of a second. 10 flat as long as he stays tied down. You know what's always kind of fun is to find out who is in our grandstands tonight. Who is in our grandstands? By applause, how many people in our grandstands tonight are 40 years of age or younger? 40 and younger. Where are you? Woo! Okay, how many of you out there by applause are 40 and older and you've never felt better in your life? Where's those people at? Are you here? Huh?
That's some good bolstering there.
Thank you. Thank you.
There's a lot of over 40 people here.
Where you been? Napping?
I cheered. I'm in the category.
Yeah, which one?
Over 40.
Hey, T-Natch and his great horse did, and they're off to the running and to the races. And one of our great champions, come on, Dean, we're with you. Yes, sir. Ooh, buddy, yes. T-Natch comes in at 8.3 as he remounts and rides ahead on that beautiful horse that he calls Sid. That is the 7-time Canadian tie-down open horse of the year for the 10-time Canadian finalists. We make it official. How about a little more for one of our fan favorites tonight? 8.3 for Dean Edge.
All right, all of you single girls go woohoo!
Holy moly! Lots of them out there.
All of you single girls, cover your eyes. The next guy riding in, Stetson Vest, is the newest Wrangler model, girls. And he's spoken for. He is spoken for, so cover your eyes. Don't look. Shanae Shiner, one of our Miss Rodeo America, great talents from a few years ago as his beautiful bride. NFR qualifier, making his first trip to Edmonton for the CFR. A nephew to Strand Smith, world champion. What year? 08? 09?
Yeah, let's go with it. Yeah.
I think 08.
Yeah.
This is one of the ropinest families that we've ever had in the world of rodeo. Here, come on, Stetson, hurry. Get it on, get it on, get it on, get it on. Hurry. 9-1 is good for second today. So I noticed when I said, all you single girls go, woohoo, I noticed you were going. What's up with that? Huh?
I just wanted to make sure everybody's having a good time. I was looking.
He was looking hard, Brad.
I know, a little harder than usual. I'm not sure what's up.
I couldn't see the section. Would you mind doing that again?
Looked like a Saskatchewan gopher.
It's a, yeah.
Jumping up.
That's right. I've heard those are, yeah.
So there's a new record. I just seen one the other day in November. No. Gopher up.
Yep. Really?
Yep, never heard of it.
No way. Well, hopefully we can maybe learn a little bit more about that gopher. You, when you were talking about temperature and you were talking about Texas.
Yeah.
You know what? Edmonton was warmer than Texas yesterday. Nicer here than, yeah. Kyle Lucas from Carstairs, Alberta is coming at us right now. Another one of our second generation superstars, the third time that he has made the trip to the Canadian finals. 2016 Alberta Circuit Champion. Got that award bestowed upon him on a Monday night as he is setting up to win the go round. Can he stay strong, tie tight? There it is. Flight comes down at 9-7. 9.7 seconds as he remounts to ride ahead for those 6 seconds to pass. So 9.7 for Kyle Lucas, if we can make it official, which we do. And speaking of some more of our award winners, congratulations to the lovely lady to my right. Maxine Baird won this year's Janet Vold Memorial Award. Congratulations to you, Maxine, and thank you for everything you do. Alongside Brenda Vold, who won that award last year, we are so very lucky to have these two lovely ladies beside us, keeping us on the straight and narrow.
Well, when you want the job done right, you hire a woman, right, ladies? Huh? Thank you, and welcome to Judy and Bervadon Kessler behind the scenes together with Brenda and Maxine, taking care of the numbers, taking care of the payoff, the checks, the monies, the times, the scores, all of the good stuff. Congratulations to you as well.
I was talking about our medium committees of the year. Again, congratulations to the TP Creek Stampede, Field of Dreams Stampede, and our large committee of the year goes once again to the Pinocchio Stampede, and our small committee of the year, Cowtown Pro Rodeo in Maple Creek, Saskatchewan.
Congrats to all of our winners. By the way, a lot of volunteers surround us here at Northlands. Do you know that in 2015, Northlands volunteers gave nearly 3,000 hours to help make the CFR a success? Thank you to the 90,000 guests that were part of our program. Ren Richard from Utah. He's been here a couple, three times before. Boy, he drew the right calf. He's got him caught in the right spot. Now, put it on him. That's what a little luck of the draw can do for you. Now, Ren Richard is no slouch. Not at all. He's a great all-around talent, a former All-State quarterback in football, high school champion as well. But he did have the right calf tonight. That helped. How about 7.9? Make room for the new leader. Yeah, buddy.
It's a guy that I'm not sure many tight end ropers want to get on a roll right there. It's a little momentum behind him. He's a scary cat right there.
You betcha.
Here's another one. We're bragging on a cowboy by the name of Morgan Grant. Morgan Grant, who now hails from Didsbury, Alberta, went to his fifth Canadian Finals Rodeo. And this is a guy that we already met. He is the only man to qualify in two events here this year. What an incredible honor it is. Well, Morgan Grant in the tie down rope and the steer wrestling. Former $100,000 champion at the Calgary Stampede. All right, Morgan, we're with you. Everybody ready? There it is. 9 seconds flat for the newlywed, the former Canadian champion. And we spoke too soon. Well, that is going to be one of them nasty no times. We talk about those 6 seconds that have to pass. They did not in that case for Morgan Grant, so that will be a no time for his efforts. Not going to work for that cowboy here this evening.
Well, 14 was a great year for Manchizawa from Chubbuck, Idaho. He got out of Northlands with the Canadian title and has qualified for his NFR one more time this year. It's going to be his 9th time to Las Vegas. Shazam Shazawa. He earned the right to be called that because of his speed on the ground. He's a great basketball player, and he has won the National Finals Rodeo before. You can do it here 6 times better than anybody, or you can do it in Las Vegas 10 times better than anybody. That's a lot. It takes a lot of consistency to get that job done. Beautiful wife, Allie, and 2 girls cheering him on all summer long. Shazawa back to try to win another title at Northland. All right, up and down, wrap them up. Yep, there it is. Not probably what he was hoping for tonight, but it's gonna be consistent for that average that we've already talked about quite a little bit.
Shazam.
You are watching some of the most expensive horses in our game here. Look at Crash, see what I'm saying? Look at him. Yeah. He's looking all through the grandstands. Yeah. What are you looking so hard for?
I'm looking up at all the people. There's a guy way up there waving. I see all those people.
The beautiful people. Yeah, the beautiful people.
Yeah, way up there. There's a whole bunch, too. I see them all up there. Look, I've been watching too much politics on TV. Really got
always, always politicking, huh? Even in the cheap seats. That's where it matters. Taking you now to Riley Warren, Stenton, Alberta. Riley backs on in that corner. He comes to his fourth Canadian finals. All right, here we go. We're set up. We need to finish strong. Come on, Riley. Yes, you did. 8-7, if and when that calf stays tied down for those elusive 6 seconds. Riley Warren's another guy like Matt Chisawa, was a great high school basketball player, a great athlete. You can see it. A lot of these tie down ropers played a lot of other sports. The athleticism really shines through in this event. It's going to work tonight. So Riley Warren, he'll be in the books at 8-7.
A couple of the spots that he picked up the win this year, Williams Lake Armstrong, over the long weekend in September. One of the very few night rodeos in Canada. It's got a feel in Armstrong like nowhere else.
Doesn't it? You bet.
Got him caught. Come on, Lee. Come on. One little bobble. Unfortunately, on night number one. It's all right. Get it out of the way. Get it out of the way. There's five more. Five more. Plenty of time.
That's right.
Put it out of your mind. Got to get a good night's sleep and come back tomorrow and do it again. With this beautiful weather, it's hard to concentrate on CFR.
Sure.
This has been the most beautiful year ever.
Yeah, what a different feel. You know what we were talking about yesterday, and when you got into town, we were saying they broke the record yesterday, 19 and a half degrees Celsius. I think the previous record was like 17, and I think it helped a lot of our farmers out in the fields the last little while, which we needed up here. So hopefully all of our great fans that are in the agricultural industry, hopefully this warm weather was good to you. Well, speaking about being good to us, Al Bouchard has been that way year after year after year. The number is 16. It's hard to believe that he's qualified here on 16 different occasions. That's incredible. For two decades, this guy has been in the conversation for a Canadian title, and he's going to do it again. Come on, Al. Come on, Al. Yep, yep, yep. Everyone needs to hang on, okay? I'm going to take a deep breath. It's official, 7-7 for Al Bouchard. I'm going to tell you a story, and it's not an excuse about this guy. He can't even shake your hand right now. His hand has been so banged up and beat up, but he fights through the pain, and he's 7-7 tonight. That is why he is an icon and one of the greatest tight end ropers in Canadian history. Al Bouchard, buddy, I'm proud of you.
That tall guy will take your money anytime, buddy. Anytime. Here comes the reigning horse of the year. Just newly crowned the 2016 Horse of the Year. They call him TJ. Announcers all over the world of rodeo have said, that great horse TJ. 1,000 times, I'll bet. He's awesome. Come on, Logan Bird, 7.6. It's yours. Oh, I thought he was going to be a little closer. But an 8.2 will work just fine. They've won over $300,000 just in the last 2 years on that horse. Congratulations to Logan Bird. He is our season leader, the highest money earner of the year so far. And turning in an 8.2 tonight. Wow. That's a great night to start off with. 7-9, 8-3, 8-2, a couple of those. And, of course, the fast time. To the tall man that you were bragging on earlier.
You know, when you sit right in the onset of our tight end open, it's going to be one to watch. But tonight, it goes to the Canadian champion and the great Canadian veteran. How about Al Bouchard, 7-7 on night number one at the Canadian finals. Rodeo Al. It's about to get underway, and it's going to start with the British Columbia Cowgirl coming into her third Canadian finals. We welcome back the lovely Katie Garthwaite as she makes her way down that alleyway. Around three round roll your barrels. You need to leave them standing. That's the name of the game. You tip one over, that is a 5-second penalty, okay? They've got to be clean. Here she comes. She is on a young horse. This is a horse called Shoe. This is a 5-year-old mare. And she gets around turn number two, the third and final turn. Edmonton, you know what to do. You guys are outstanding, as is she tonight, 14.680 to get us started.
All right, let's go to Tony Dixon now for Millerville. She's a 2-time consecutive qualifier and a brand new grandma. You moms and grandmas in the grandstands, when she gets around barrel number three, you know what to do. Don't wait on me. Here we go. $14.98, starting them off pretty fast.
Well, Coma Gilbert from Maple Creek, Saskatchewan, comes to her very first Canadian Finals rodeo. She has had an extremely successful semi-pro career, and she's a fourth-year nursing student at the University of Lethbridge. She's riding a brand new horse just to slip on that first barrel, and she will change leads right there and come out of the second turn. Well, her good horse is not with her this weekend, regrettably so, and a 5-second penalty. On top of the total run time for Tony Gilbert, 15.672 plus the 5. That is a total run time of 20.672.
Don't knock them down. You can knock them all around. Just don't knock them down. The next young lady at 18 years old is a newlywed. October 29th. She just got married. Kayla Melby Small. Atta girl, she's headed to Las Vegas with this horse as well. Come on, Kayla, turn and burn, turn and burn. Ooh, 14.96. Everybody's chasing Petey Gunthwaite on the top of the ground.
2 years ago, Sydney Danes came into the Canadian Finals rodeo as a rookie. She went on to win 3 rounds. Well, she comes back in 2016 on that same horse. Born and raised on the Dane Ranch, as this is Flame. Well, the starting striker for the University of Alberta Panda soccer team. Whoop, come on, sit down. Everybody get loud. Well, Sydney Danes from Innis Vale, Alberta, 14.989. Well, shows you how fast Katie Gunthwaite was to start us off.
Boy, I don't know, maybe they won't beat her tonight. Here comes Nancy Chabai. She's from Taylor, Alberta. She's the reigning Canadian champion when the dust had settled here a year ago. This is the lady that walked away with the title and the horse of the year from last year, 2015, Wicked, they call her. Most of them are choosing the right barrel tonight. Maybe that'll help. Maybe it'll make a difference. All right, ladies, you know what to do. Let's go. Hey, number two spot, 14.88. That's worth $9,000 right now.
Hey, let's go, Carmen Pazavan, a CFR rookie. Well, a super talented horse trainer. This is a 5-year-old Mexican mare that she won the Derby Super Stakes on. This is a horse called Rip, and what a rookie run it is. Carmen Pazavan gets around all three in a 15.068.
Here comes a horse trainer and a horse named Freeway. The cowgirl is Lynette Brodaway from Brooks, Alberta. Big wins this year in Sundry, Leduc, and Bonneville. Kind of easing into the arena. Come on, Lynette. Oh, no. A little plus five.
She's a little runaway.
And 24, whoops, including the penalty, 19.848. 19.848, down to within 1/1000th of a second is how we'll time them here at the CFR.
You know, I was reading an article on Renee LeClaire a couple of days ago, and it started with, it's a matter of time. Yep, that's simply what it was, because this lady is so talented. And she makes a big turn on that first barrel, but another lady that comes in not on her number one horse. She gets around that Ram Rodeo barrel and finds fashion, turn number two. Here's where we make a little noise, okay? 15.272 for Renee, 15.272.
So the next cowgirl from Texas, Jackie Gannert, wrapped up last year's Rookie of the Year title at the NFR in Las Vegas. It came right down to the last rodeo of the year. She is number two in the world this year, headed back to Las Vegas. Come on, Jackie, throw the reins at him, hurry! 15-11. Katie Garthwaite has got her fingers crossed right now.
Yeah, she does. You know what? We maybe underestimated that run as it was the first one on the ground. Well, she put a smoking run together. They're trying to catch her. Well, can the lovely lady from Hermiston, Oregon? We're about to find out. Callahan Cosley comes to her very first Canadian final. She is the 2015 National College Champion. And one of three barrel racers in her family. She is awesome. The Oregonians moving to the top of the class. How about 14.645? Callahan, nice run.
I'm going to put all my money on the last girl.
Good.
Okay, she's on the bottom of the ground. But this is the horse of the year, 2016, Racing Kirsty White. Big Valley, Alberta. If you're from Alberta, let's start making a little noise right here. All right, come on, everybody, give her a push. Oh. 14-90 tonight. 14-90. That was a great barrel race on night number one. Leave it to the 11th cowgirl to turn in the fastest time of the night. That was amazing.
Oh, it certainly was. What a setup in our ladies' barrel race. And like we saw in the tie down, like we saw in the bareback riding competition, we are making all sorts, well, all sorts of headway. You know what? If you watch real close, she won the round with no reins tonight. You look at that right there as the reins flip to the other side. How about you salute Callahan Crossley, your round winner right there. How about that for a cowgirl? Callahan, huge congratulations to you. A lovely lady from Oregon starts us off right.
Now, we have a little bit of unfinished business to talk about. Back in the bronc riding, I believe we're picking up a Kessler horse for our cowboy who was offered the option of a re-ride or a second chance. It's the best rule that we have in rodeo, and I love to have it. Mystic River for our cowboy, and it is Leighton Green. He got fouled coming out of the chute gate, is what our pro officials are saying. So he gets another chance. Mystic River from Kessler's, ready to roll. Come on, Leighton. We need a little help down here.
Today I don't feel like doing anything. I just wanna lay in my bed.
I know, I know. All right, the next time they open the gate, I'll need everybody to cheer, okay? Let the horse know you want to see him in action,
okay? All right, let's try it. Mick Kessler back in horse on a superstar cowboy that qualified not only the Canadian finals, he was in the top 20 in the world standings this year. Comes from a great family, the former Canadian novice saddle bronc riding champion. Come on, let's go. Yep. Wow. When the Kessler family puts a bucking horse underneath you, I suggest you get ready. That dude, he needs some people power, and when you see the Remax replay, you are going to see why. You want to talk about rattle your cage. You watch about the third jump right here. He gets whipped back, but he never quits charging the front end. He is taking an absolute beating. That is a pile of abuse as our Canadian Pro Rodeo Sports Medicine team moves in to check on the situation for Layton Green. I don't care what the numbers are going to be. That guy needs a little bit from you right now. I'm not, 79 to ease the pain for Layton Green. 79, going to be the number.
Bull riding fans, are you ready? Come on, slap your hands together. Get a little rhythm going. Come on. Show them how, Crash.
It starts with Tanner Gerlitz from Moden, Alberta. His eighth trip to our Canadian Finals Rodeo, the 2006 Canadian champion. Is matching up with a bucking bull from the outlaw firm that we call Mr. Sunshine. Here's a big souped up spinner of a bucking bull, and you can see that yellow horn dune getting ready. But Tanner Gerlitz was another than one of those cowboys that punched his ticket at the final weekend of the regular season. He had to win. He had one chance. You back him in a corner, he is going to come out fighting. Tanner Gerlitz proved why he is one of the greatest cowboys from one of the greatest families of all time. His grandfather, Wilf Gerlitz, was a five-time Canadian champion. Tanner Gerlitz, a Canadian champion. And his beautiful wife and baby girl are watching on as Tanner makes sure that everything is right and ready. As he gets ready to nod his head, there are going to be two cowboys that will put their life on the line. And they're two of the greatest in cowboy protection as we recognize Mr. Scott Way on the far side. And his fifth trip, it's Brett Monia, as our bullfighters are ready. Tanner Gerlitz, it's all about you. Let's get you outside to the big pen. Now, Mr. Sunshine, we'll give you a chance tonight. That is a promise. Like it was in the Bronc Titan, this pen of bulls will take you to the pay window. Had a chance last night at our Niner Champions to talk to one of our bull riders. And they said, you know what? Probably the best pen of bulls that we've seen in the last 10 or 12 years.
Any day now.
Just the opinion of a few, okay? You know, as we look at it, Wayne Tanner's been here on eight different occasions. You say, what's happening in there? He knows how important that first jump is. He knows how important that first move out of that ram buck and shoot it is so crucial. He nods his head at an inopportune time. He set himself up for failure.
We've been waiting for a long time. Yes, we've been waiting for a long time. We've been waiting for a long time.
I think what they're probably going to do is roll that bull up a chute once we get our next man out and done. That's going to be Timothy Lipset. Saskatchewan in the house tonight. Make a little noise. Where's Saskatchewan at, huh? Come on. Lumsden, Saskatchewan. First time CFR. He finished up 17th in Canada last year. Nearly made the cut a year ago. And he's a big, tall guy. 6'2". You might say, oh, well, that's too tall for it to be a bull rider. No way. This guy's a winning son of a gun. Again, back to Armstrong. For a big win in September, Timothy Lipset. You should be cheering the loudest, Crash. Saskatchewan guy.
I am. I was looking. There's lots of people from the motherland here. Yeah. Lots of, let's hear it, Saskatchewan. Let's hear from you. Are you in the house?
Rough Rider fans, come on. Here we go. Whoa. One word could describe that little matchup.
Okay.
Violent.
Violent.
Sheesh.
Yeah.
This little move right here where he got him down off the side, right there. Boy, if that bull would have thrown his head to the right, he would have mashed him right in the face. Thank goodness for the first bull out, for the first time CFR guy, no injuries. Aren't you glad for that, everybody? Timothy walks away unscathed tonight. I think they're rolling him now. So it's hard to see, but from the camera shot that we had earlier when he was fighting with that bull in there, I think the bull was squatting down, mashing his rear end on the back of the chute. They don't want the bulls to do that. They want them to stand up straight on all four legs. That gives you a good shot to come out of there. This, believe it or not, is the most dangerous place in the entire arena, inside that chute. When you're out here in the arena, it's between you and the animal. There's some give. There's a little bit of give in that dirt, a little bit of give in the bull, a little bit of give in the cowboy. No give in steel chutes. They can mash your leg against there and break a bone in the blink of an eye. That's the reason safety is so critical when they're inside that chute.
Well said, and we take a look at it, and Donnie Johansson, our Hall of Famer and arena director, our shoot boss, who does such an incredible job, alongside our timed event shoot boss, and Bob Wilson and Keenan Vine with the Calgary Stampede, they make sure that everything is running accordingly, and like you mentioned, their number one concern is going to be the safety of the bull rider, but Tanner Gerlitz, a cowboy that's been here on 8 different occasions, knows what he needs to do. He's not going to nod his head at an inopportune time, and you've got over $12,000 on the line and a chance at the Canadian title. Well, 6 rounds, but 7 chances to win money when you put the average into it. Mr. Sunshine from the Outlaw Buckers, who were last year's Canadian Stock Contractors of the year previous, I should say. Alongside Wayne Gold and the Calgary Stampede the past few years, our award-winning contractors, as Tanner Gerlitz is just trying to get it right. Here it is. Come on, buddy. Yep. Oop. Get up and get out. Out. Man, he takes a shot. Tanner Gerlitz takes a huge shot as our bullfighters slide on in. And he gets up and said, that's okay. I'm all right. I'll be back tomorrow. You watch him right here as Big Mr. Sunshine jumps out of it, comes back the other way, and then right there. Wow. Can you say something to the Canadian champion and Tanner Gerlitz? The tough shot as he takes a shot there, and then it is time to get airborne.
Whew. What did you say that bull's name was?
That is Mr. Sunshine.
Holy moly, I hope we don't have one named Stormy Skies. I'd hate to see what it's like.
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone.
Wow.
It's not warm when she's gone.
Obviously wasn't named for his disposition, was he?
Hey, get ready, we're going back to Saskatchewan, buddy. Jared Parsonage, Maple Creek, Saskatchewan. 2 consecutive qualifications here. That name is familiar. It's a great family. And this young man's a great tie-down roper, team roper a little bit as well. He won, here's your story again. He won the first round. Your story, you're gonna stick to it.
I'm sticking to it all week. That's my story. Give me one thing.
Parsonage has teamed up with Compton Bound from the Calgary Stampede herd. They were first in Pinoca on this bull with an 87.25 score this summer. Great bull right here. But this pin's loaded pretty deep for night number one. I didn't expect them to load such a wolfy pin on night number one, but they did.
They did, and when I was talking to the learners, so when I talked to one of the bull riders, is ready? Come on, Parsonage.
Come on. Help him a little bit out there. Come on. Watch it, watch it, watch it, watch it. Ladies and gentlemen, how about them bullfighters? Nice job, guys. Nice job. Scoreboard says number one easily, 83.25. Nice. Nice, nice, nice.
This now's a good time to remind everybody he's from Saskatchewan, hey, Crash? Gotta say,
we got talent in the motherland. That's all I'm saying.
Well, let's go a little further than Saskatchewan. Fabian Newick, the international superstar, and he matches up with the Freakazoid from the Gerlitz. Come on, Fabe. Oh, boy. We said it before, we'll say it again. How about your bullfighters on Wednesday night?
Stand my ground, and I won't back down.
I want you to watch that replay, and I hope we get another chance, because
Brett Manya puts his life on the line. You watch as he will shoot the gap between Bull and Bull Rider. He takes it so the Cowboy can get up and walk away. Scott Way on the other side, it's teamwork. That is why those two guys are two of the best in the world. How about a little more?
You know, if you could ever teach that bull to go out on the high dive, he could be in the Olympics, that Brett.
He could be.
That was some nice spinning and flipping.
Panoka Cowboy, Wacy Finkbinder comes your way now. You should know this bull, Crash. Crooked Nose, you know that one?
Yeah. I believe there's more Saskatchewan content there.
Oh, again? Well, you are bragging it up tonight, aren't you? Crooked Nose belongs to Wayne Bold, but the Cooper family, who's been known to bring some great bucking horses and bulls to the forefront, they were involved in this one a little bit as well. This guy's a hand. It's his first time here, second generation. His dad, Jim Finkbeiner, he's a bull rider here as well. He won the Wrangler Tour Finals Championship at Armstrong, and that helped him get here to the CFR. Come on. Hey, hey, oh. Watch it, careful, watch it. It's because he doesn't have horns doesn't mean he won't wreck your whole day. And did you notice, maybe we can see it in the video, did you notice Crash kept moving backwards?
It's a tendency to do that. I've seen one less five bulls.
Do you know why? I'll tell you, no. I'll tell you why. You got to understand everything. There's a camera over here that takes shots of the bullfighters. And I do not want to obstruct any of the view of the impeccable work that these fine young gentlemen do.
He's so unselfish, you know. We're always thinking of others.
Yeah. I just give, yeah. Man.
Let's Watch go. Out. Come on. Let's try him. Tyler Pankowitz, jukebox hero for the Calgary Stampede. We're so excited to welcome back Tyler Pankowitz, a former PBR Canada National Champion. And he is pumped up, and he should be. That was a great matchup on the back of the jukebox hero for the Calgary Stampede, this year's Canadian Pro Rodeo Stock Contractors of the Year. At five-year-old Bronco Face was just what the doctor ordered. We'll put him into the number two spot, 82 1/4.
All right, here comes the money-winningest bull rider in Canada. Scotty Scheffner, Strathmore, Alberta, making his 16th trip to the CFR. Give him a little noise just for that many qualifications, huh? Outlaw, stock contracting firm, brings us the bull that was recognized as the 2014 Bucking Bull of the Year in Canada. He's called Uptight. That's what Scotty Scheffner's drawn tonight. PBR champ, Canadian champ, Calgary Stampede $100,000 champ. He's done it all. Cowboy of the Year a couple of years ago in the CPRA. Wow. And what a nice guy. You won't make any better representative, you won't make any better champion than this man right here. I'm the president of the fan club, if you can't tell. Great family. Cheering him on, Brandy, Mesa, Hadley, Oakley. I know you're here somewhere. Hang on, Scotty, hang on. Humble and gracious. I wasn't talking about you.
I thought maybe first. You know, I can't believe what happened earlier because B&W is a sponsor here, but we give away a trailer hitch.
$500 trailer.
Yeah, and I'm thinking about it now. All they had to do was shake their behind a little bit.
Yep.
I got a haircut to look like one, and I still don't get one.
Nice hairdo.
That's commitment.
That is commitment. You're just throwing caution to the wind, aren't you?
No, I'm not throwing my hair to the wind.
How many'd like to see a bull hit the barrel with Crash in it tonight? How many'd like to see that? Oh.
How many people
Come on, Scott Schiffner.
Yeah. What, like?
Let me see.
I won't. I'm a nice guy, like I said. You're. Here we go.
Come on, Scotty, help him out. Cheer him on. Cheer him on. So stay out of your barrel there for a second. Benji, do you have that song you were playing a second ago, the wobble song? See what you can do with this. Let's see if you can shake your trailer hitch.
You know what? I needed a trailer hitch too because I got a little bumper pull.
Yeah.
So I've got a little trailer hitch. This is... That's how I do my trailer hitch. Kind of looked like a bee showing where the other bees, where the pollen is, isn't it?
All right, well, ready to shake his hitch is Jordan Hanson from Okotoks, Alberta. The Fold Audio Company, Johnny Ringo. Come on. Yep. Come on. Oh, man. We look to our officials, and they say he was not there. Well, that is a cool bull from Wayne Vold and the team. That bull originated and originally came from the G Cattle Company named Jackie Gardner. Well, Johnny Ringo puts a bullet in Jordan Hanson tonight. So Jordan Hanson starts things off. He goes 0-1. We'll score for Hanson. We get set to go to our next man. Don't forget, if you've been drinking, don't drive. Alberta Transport means you can leave your vehicle right here, no charge. Here comes Lonnie West, Cadogan, Alberta. 2015 was Rookie of the Year in Canada. And at 20 years old, he's back. He wants the big bucks now. Bucking Bull, Bombshell from Outlaw. They rode this bull a year ago, same night, same time. Come on, Lonnie.
Everybody clap your hands.
Yeah, you got him. You got him.
Everybody clap your hands.
Get out of there. Get out of there.
Come
get
on,
out
y'all.
Of there.
Ooh. Check it out, y'all. Everybody clap your hands.
Oh, boy. I was hollering, get out of there, and he couldn't stand on that leg. Something went haywire when he hit the ground. So watch it again and see what happened. It looked like he kind of fell on his back. Everything looked pretty good to me, just something went wrong. Score's rolling in there. Maybe this will make his leg feel a little bit better. How about 87.5 for Lonnie West? Wow. Hey, now a little energy in the house. Let's keep it going. We're taking you to the other side. It's St. Lambert from Pinocchio, Alberta, and he matches up with the award-winning Wayne Vold Smoke Show. This 7-year-old souped-up spinner probably comes in as one of the biggest bulls in the entire competition. You talk about Wayne Vold, you talk about an incredible set of bucking horses, but he has brought with him an outstanding set of bulls this year. It's about opportunity, and he's got it. Zane Lambert was a runner-up to a Canadian title last year. Said, tonight's the night I'm gonna get off to a good start. He won 2 rounds last year. He placed in 2 others. Got his battle back from some injury this year. We banged him up and we beat him up a little earlier in the 2016 campaign to Safely Pro Rodeo. He battled back to ride to the Calgary Stampede, and he's returned to his winning ways. We just saw a big 87.5, but I'll tell you what. Zane Lambert does things right, does his job right. On the back of the Vold Rodeo Company's Big Bucker, come on! You know, I hate to tell you, that was the rubber match right there. Zane Lambert has rode that bull. That bull has bucked him off now twice.
And I promise you this, you may not find a nicer man in our entire industry. Could you make Zane Lambert feel just a little bit better, would you?
So listen to this. Dakota Butter's the number one man coming into our CFR tonight. And Brock Radford, who's going to ride next, he's number two. The difference between the two, $34. $34. That's nothing. That is nothing.
Holy. That is almost an entire month's wages for me. Nothing.
For Brock, it is his first CFR, 21 years old. And tonight we're going to team him up with Cuckoo. They named this bull after you, Crash.
What'd they name it? Handsome Devil.
No, not handsome. Guess again.
I'm a sweetheart.
No.
Cool dude.
Cuckoo Kong.
What?
Cuckoo Kong.
Cuckoo Kong?
Cuckoo Kong. Gerlitz brings him to town.
Oh, well, there you go.
There you go. Brock Radford, first CFR. Only just a few bucks a month's wages for the clown behind the number one man coming in. He turned pro in 2014. This year, big wins at the Cint Series Finals Championship in Calgary, High Prairie, Alberta, Medicine Hat, Alberta. Just a few more of the big wins for him. Come on, Brock. 88 or more to take the lead on night number one.
It's pretty cool to say night number one, you got to be 88 or better. Every event we've made some magic in, and that is what's so incredible about the Canadian Finals. When you bring the greatest rodeo athletes, not only from North America, but all across the world, and the greatest livestock that Canada has to offer. Well, it's making magic, and we're going to try and do it again as we continue to set the stage. Now, Brock Radford is a second-generation cowboy, and he, well, rides with a big motor. There's maybe no cowboy that's as competitive as this young cowboy right here. No matter that he's a rookie, he wants to win first every time he nods his head. Yep, come on, keep hustling. Yep, stay with him. How about a little sum for a CFR rookie? Come on, he's pumped up. Give it back to him.
What an effort. Do you see his upper body, his free arm? He's moving his feet every jump. Keep hacking at him the whole ride. That was a great effort.
You get used to it because that is Brock Radford fashion. He's in tonight. How about 83.5?
Hey, yeah, I want to shoot, baby. Shoot.
Oh. How you doing, baby?
Here comes the number one man, Dakota Butter from Saskatchewan. 2014 and 15 Canadian champion, season leader 3 years in a row, second generation bull rider, and tonight we got him on one from C5 called Neon Magic. Welcome back to our Cowboy Lifesavers Horseback tonight. Dakota just turned 24 years old just a few days ago, November 6th. When you talk about raw ability and natural talent, this kid was born to be a bull rider. This is a rematch. He's got a little blood in his eye because this bull has gotten him onto the ground before. And if you ride him, you should be up into that neighborhood to win first or second. But the judges, they don't care what we think. They're watching it. They're on the ground. They make the call. Season leader needing an 87 3/4 or more to change everything tonight. That bull's kind of throwing a fit in there.
You know, we talked about the same situation with Tanner Gerlitz. Finding that perfect opportunity, one chance. Dakota Butter, like you mentioned, he comes in as a season leader, but is a Canadian champion not once, but twice. He can be the first ever bull rider to make it a three-peat. He does things right. He's got momentum on his side. He just came back from Las Vegas 2 days ago at the World Finals. Represented our great nation. He rides ranked bulls maybe better than anybody in the world right now. In Canada, 2016, I think they're gonna dig him on out of there as he kind of regroups. He comes in with the highest riding and winning percentage of any bull rider on Canadian soil this year.
So, if you were a betting man,
yeah,
and you could go to the tables in Las Vegas and put your money on him, that'd be the one.
He's the guy.
God, God.
So, Crash, what are you doing?
Well, you know what? I am so happy.
Yeah.
Not only is it the first night of the Canadian Finals,
right?
But it is also the first night of no more U.S. election.
Yay. Yay.
You know, this is one thing that Canada has got big league over the U.S.
Believe me.
Our campaign's here last 2 weeks, and if hockey night in Canada's on, they just don't run. Okay? I mean, watching that down there, I love your, you know, lovely little country you have down there. But I'm telling you, man, there is more cover-ups than a cat with diarrhea going on down there.
You are absolutely...
Wow. Here's what I don't understand. They have about two people running for the President of the United States, and they have about 50 for Miss USA. That's the choices. You get two or you get 50. It kind of seems to be backwards to me.
One or the other. One or the other. Dakota Butter. Neon Magic. We need a little help down here. A little help. Wow. He can hear you now. Wow. I talked about the effort a moment ago from Brock Radford. Same thing from Dakota
that
Butter.
Was before.
Yep. We were talking about his great accolades so far of the year. Scores rolling in. It's an 87-point score. 87 for Dakota Butter. Boy, this is going to be neck and neck right down to the wire with Brock Radford and Dakota Butter here in the bull riding.
It's going to be absolutely outstanding. What an incredible night of bull riding it was, like we had in every one of our major events. And when we talk about the number one gun in our bull riding competition, a huge 87.5-point ride. Well, Lonnie West, that is a good sign. He is a horseback. 87.5, the two-time Canadian Finals Rodeo qualifier takes home the top honors in our BMW Trailer Hitches bull riding on night number one.
Wow.